Look at this robot animation. The claw is connected to the arm, which is connected to the body, and everything animates together smoothly. This was made with layer parenting, a powerful feature that lets you connect layers in a scene so that changes in the position, angle, or scale of a parent layer automatically affect child layers. In this video, we'll learn how layer parenting works and what you can make with it. We'll also learn about invisible null objects that can be used together with layer parenting to make more sophisticated animations across parented layers. We'll start by learning how to set a layer's parent. For this project, we'll introduce several different layers one by one to show how a complex animation can be made from very simple pieces. Here, we'll be assembling and animating a crane. Most of the pieces have been modified from simple shapes. We've also adjusted the pivot points for you, so the segments will rotate correctly. Please see our video on pivot points to learn more about how to work with them. If you'd like to work with the project you see on screen, download the project package to follow along. We'll start with the layer's positions as shown on screen, and we're going to use the base of the crane as our parent layer. We haven't set up any parenting yet, so when we change its position, none of the other layers move. Let's parent the stripe layer to the base. Tap on the stripe layer to select it, then tap the Layer Parent button. A menu will drop down listing all the existing layers in the project. Note that the layer that is selected on the timeline is disabled. This is because a layer cannot be its own parent, even indirectly. You may occasionally see multiple layers disabled, if selecting them would create a circular connection. Let's choose the base. In this connection of two layers, the base layer is the parent and the stripe layer is the child. Notice that the layer parent icon has changed to show that the selected layer has a parent. If you ever want to remove a parent connection from a layer, just select the child layer, go to the layer parent menu, and choose None. Now we have two connected layers. The base layer is the parent of the stripe layer, which means that the stripe layer is a child of the base layer. Let's see how they interact. If we tap on the base layer and drag it in the preview area, we can see that the stripe layer moves with it. The parent layer controls the position of the child layer. However, if we select the stripe layer and drag it, we can see that the position of the parent is unaffected by any changes in the child layer. Now let's parent the three wheel layers to the base layer. As you can see, one parent can have multiple children, but each child can only have a single parent. Note that parenting is not affected by layer order. We could change the order of these layers in the timeline, putting the wheels in front of the base, but the base layer will still be the parent. Parenting also works at a distance. If we move the orange segment of the crane so that it's not overlapping the base, and then parent it to the base, it still moves in tandem with the base. But for our project, we want the orange segment to appear attached to the base. So let's tap Undo to move the base where it was, and then we can move the orange segment back into position. If you make a mistake with the positioning of parent and child layers, adjusting the child layer is the easiest way to fix it. Let's keep building our crane by parenting the yellow segment to the orange one. We could parent the yellow segment directly to the base, but if we did that, it would move with the base, but it would become disconnected when we rotate the orange segment. Parenting yellow to orange fixes that issue. Notice that we are creating a hierarchy from red to orange to yellow. Every child segment moves with its parent, and even the parent of its parents as well. Let's parent the remaining segments in order. Like position and rotation, changes in scale in a parent likewise affect child layers. When we increase the scale of the base, which is now an indirect parent of all the other layers, the rest of the crane grows as you would expect. Now that all of our layers are connected in a hierarchy, we can take advantage of the real power of layer parenting to make it move just like a real crane. First, let's give the crane an object to pick up by adding a car shape in front of it. Then, let's set three keyframes for the base to move it forward and backward in the preview. As expected, all the layers are affected by this movement, since the base layer is at the top of the parent chain. Next, we'll animate the orange segment, rotating it back and forward. As we expect, the rest of the arm follows along. Let's animate the remaining segments so that the animation ends with the crane arching downward to the car layer. It's a bit tricky to align all the segments so the end segment ends up right over the car, but there's an easier way to accomplish this that we'll get to shortly. So far, the animation looks much more interesting now that everything is working together. Here's a neat trick. Anything that affects the position, rotation, or scale of a layer will also influence child layers that are connected to it. And that includes effects applied to the parent layer. For example, if auto shake is added to a parent layer, any child layers will shake in perfect unison. Effects that can influence child layers in this way are marked with this tag in the effect browser. There are a couple of effects that work a bit differently when applied to child layers. Move along path is one of them. Normally, applying this effect to a layer will cause the layer to move along the vector outline of the layer, just below it on the timeline. However, if move along path is applied to a layer with a parent, it will use the vector outline of the parent layer instead, allowing for much greater flexibility. Another effect is the aptly named parenting helper effect. This effect can be applied to child layers to provide greater control over their behaviours. Let's say we want our crane to bend down and latch onto the car. We can manually adjust the rotation of each segment so that the claw is in the intended position and at the correct angle. However, we can save a lot more time by removing its animation keyframes, adding parenting helper, and setting rotate to locked. Now the claw will stay attached to the green segment without rotating with it, or any of the other segments. The locked setting is useful for when you want to control the child layer's rotation or scale directly. The normal setting causes the child layer to behave as it would without the parenting helper effect. The weighted setting lets you fine-tune the degree to which the child is affected by the parent's rotation or scale change. For example, setting the end segment's weighted rotation value to 200% will cause it to rotate twice as much as its parent rotates. Feel free to experiment with weighted values, as you can always put the settings back to normal or locked at any time. Now, let's look at null objects. Figuratively, that is, since we can't actually see them. A null object is an invisible layer. By itself, it's not very useful. But together with parenting, it can affect other layers on the timeline. To add a null object, tap the Add Layer button, go to Object, and then tap on Null. Although we see the outline of a box in the preview, indicating where the null object is, this will not appear when the video is exported. As you may expect, turning off a null object's visibility has no effect. Null objects are very useful when combined with parenting. For example, if you want to animate move and transform on multiple layers simultaneously, just parent all of those layers to a single null object and animate the null object instead. Remember our robot animation? Let's say that we want to animate its eyes by moving them up and down. Since there is a layer for each eye, we could easily parent one to the other, then add keyframes to change the position of the parent. Simple enough. But what if we also want to animate just one eye independently? For example, to create a wink. Instead, let's add a null object, parent it to the robot's head, and parent each eye to the null object. Now we can animate the eye movement by adding keyframes to the null object. We no longer have to worry about which eye is the parent of the other, or whether changing the position of one will affect the alignment of the other. We can now animate the eyes individually, or together, with the null object. Parenting with null object is also useful when you want to animate movement independently on different axes. For example, if a camera is parented to a null object, the camera can steadily zoom in on the Z or Z axis, while the null object moves back and forth. This type of combination is perfect for creating dynamic camera animations. You may have noticed that when we tap on a layer with position keyframes, we can see the line indicating the layer's movement path. Because the robot's body layer only moves from left to right, its path is a straight line. But watch what happens when we set keyframes on the null object, moving upward as the robot moves to the right. Now the movement trail of the body has become a diagonal line, as it inherits the movement of the parent layer. Now watch what happens to the body's motion path when we change the easing curve for the upward movement of the null object. The movement path is a curve. Normally, layers change position between keyframes in a straight line. But by combining easing with the position change of a parent layer and child layer, you can move child layers in curved paths. Let's go back to our crane and go a little deeper into how layer parenting works in different circumstances. A child layer's move and transform settings are added to the parent settings. For example, if the parent has a 45-degree rotation and the child has a 45-degree rotation, the total visual rotation applied to the child will be the combination of the two, or 90 degrees. When parenting a layer, if both of these values were preserved, you'd see the child layer jump at this time. To prevent this from happening, the child's position is automatically adjusted as you enable parenting to compensate for the parent layer's position and transform. Put another way, the relationship between the parent and child is locked in when you set the parent layer. This means that if the parent layer is already animated when you set up parenting, the position of the playhead matters. Let's try an experiment to see what can happen if we get this wrong by setting up parenting when the playhead is in the wrong position. Let's set the parent of the orange segment to none. Scroll forward a few seconds and then recreate the parenting connection. As you can see, the relative position of the two layers was locked in while the arm was detached. So now the entire crane arm will animate with the base, despite being detached from it. To fix this, you'll need to undo the parenting and set the parent again after moving the playhead to the correct position. We've covered what layer parenting and null objects are, and how you can use them to coordinate movement when animating multiple layers. Layer parenting and null objects can give you many options for animating your projects. Be ambitious and see how many moving parts you can coordinate to produce stunning animations. Be sure to show us with the hashtag #AMLayerParenting. If you found this video useful and would like to be notified about future content, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell. If you have any questions or feedback about layer parenting or null objects, please leave us a comment.